Today, I'm going to start the chapter Jainism and Buddhism of Class 9 History. In the 6th century BC, the Aryan settlements expanded to the east. There was a rapid socio-economic and political changes. This was the period of the later Vedic. Materialism and spiritualism both existed side by side. They started living a settled life. Now, with the expansion of human settlement, there was also rise in the orthodox religious beliefs and practices. Now, these orthodox religious beliefs and practices, they were not accepted by everyone. These beliefs and practices were challenged by the new sects. Now, these new sects were Jainism and Buddhism. Also, in the 6th century BC, there was emergence of thinkers like Gautam Buddha and Vardhaman Mahavira. Now let us discuss about the sources through which we got the information about Jainism and Buddhism. The sources are Angas, Triptikas and Jatakas. Now through Angas we get the informations about Jainism. It is generally accepted that whatever Lord Mahavira taught was compiled by his disciple in 12 parts called Angas. Now, based on these Angas, the series also compiled of 12 auxiliary works that came to be known as Upangas. Now, Triptikas. Triptikas gave us the information about Buddhism. Triptikas are the most important literary works of the Buddhist. They provide a glimpse of social, economic, political life in the age of Buddha. Now coming to Jatakas. Jatakas refer to the tales which describe the previous births of Buddha in both human and animal form. Jatakas throw significant light on political, economic and social condition of the people from 5th to 2nd century BC. These Jatakas also reflect Buddhist moral ethics and principles. So these are the sources through which we get the information about Jainism and Buddhism. Now let us discuss about the causes for the rise of Jainism and Buddhism. The first cause was reaction against ritualism. Now there was expensive ritualism was practiced during that period, which was not which were beyond the means of the ordinary people. Some priests hardly realized the sufferings of the common man, and this was an important cause that gave rise to faiths that were simple and inexpensive. Now, corruption in the religion. The priest encouraged the ordinary people to perform yajnas and conduct household rites beyond their means. Now the Kshatriya rulers, they protested against the domination of such priests. Now some of the Kshatriya prince were the one who founded Jainism and Buddhism. Now coming to the rigid caste system, there was a division in the society. The society was divided into Brahmanas, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. Now, casteism had become so rigid that person from one caste could not become a member of the other caste. Now, coming to the language. Now, Sanskrit was the sacred language that was most of the Vedic literature was also composed in Sanskrit. The priestly class gave discourses and chanted mantras in this language, and this the common people failed to understand. So therefore, many people began to look for an alternative religion that they could understand better. Now, coming to the political situation, in the 6th century BC, Magadha was ruled by Bimisara. Now, and later by Ajatasatru. Now, both these rulers were liberal and tolerant. They too were free from the Brahmanic influence and condemned certain social evils in their kingdoms. Now, when the opportunity came, they patronized both Jainism and Buddhism. nor agricultural economy. Now, killing of animals and perform sacrifices was against the interest of the farmers. Now, the farmers needed a religion that would give protection to the animals. Both Jainism and Buddhism preached non-violence and were against animal sacrifices. So these were the reason which the common people, for because of which the common people went to seek the religion such as Jainism and Buddhism. Now let us discuss about the religion Jainism. Now the doctrines of the Jains were preached by the saints or Acharya, known as the Tirthankaras, and Mahavira was the 24th Tirthankaras. He was considered as the founder of Jainism as he popularized Jainism. Now, talking about the life of Mahavira, he was born in Kundagrama near Vaishali in Bihar. He belonged to a Kshatriya family and he got married to Yashoda. Now, from childhood, he was absorbed in spiritual pursuits. And at the age of 30, he renounced the world and roamed around practicing severe penance for 12 years. At last, he obtained the supreme knowledge. Now, his followers came to be known as Jinas or Jains. And those who have, and what does Jains mean? Jains means those who have conquered their desires. Now coming to the teachings of Jainism, it is said that Jainism preaches five vows, and these five vows were ahimsa. Ahimsa means non-violence. Then acharya or asteya. Asteya means not stealing. Satya, not telling a lie. Then aparigraha, non-possessing property. And Brahmacharya, practicing chastity. So these were the five vows that was preached by Jainism. Now coming to the ninth truth, beside the five vows and other general doctrines of Jainism, Jains are expected to have knowledge of the nine truths. What were the nine truths? Jiva, that is living things, ajiva, non-living things, punya, that is result of good deeds, pap, that is sins, ashrav, that is good deeds, sanvar, hindrance in the way of karma, then bandha, that is bondage, nirjara, destruction of karmas, and moksha, that is salvation. Now let us discuss about the doctrines of Jainism. Mahavira preached that the ultimate goal of a man is to attain freedom from the worldly bonds or to attain moksha. Now, how can we attain moksha? Through these three ratnas, that is right faith, right knowledge and right conduct. Now, these three ratnas means that is ultimate goal of a man to attain freedom from worldly bonds. Now, coming to karma. Karma is one should be responsible for one's own action. Equality, that is, he preached universal brotherhood. Eternal soul, that is immortality of soul. Mahavira said that the body dies. He said that the body dies, but not the soul. That is known as immortality of soul. Now, salvation. Now, like the Hindus, Jains believe in moksha or freedom from the cycle of birth and rebirths. Now, believe in penance, that is to die of starvation called santhara, was considered a virtue. Now, Jainism laid so much stress on severe penance that only few people could lead such an austere life. Now, these were the doctrines of Jainism. Now, Jainism was divided into two sects, that is Swetambaras and the Digambaras. Now, who were Swetambaras? They were in white clothes and covered their faces with a small white cloth to avoid killing of insects or germs. They fasted but did not believe in extreme penance and austerity. Now Digambaras, they wore sky clad and did not believe in covering their bodies. They kept long fast and led austere life. Now Swetambaras were led by Stulambhadra and Digambaras were led by Bhadrabhanu. Now these were the two groups Jains were divided into. Now coming to the decline of Jainism. Why Jainism declined? Because Jainism preached rigid austerity, that is theory of ahimsa, was extended even to wearing of clothes. This religion did not spread to the foreign countries. This was also one of the reasons for the decline of Jainism. It did not get royal patronage from contemporary rulers. Though it advocated equality of men, it did not do away totally with the high and low positions in the society. Now during Gupta period, Hinduism became popular once again and Jainism got restricted to certain parts of the country. So these were the reasons for the decline of Jainism. So here we are ending up with Jainism and we will continue with Buddhism in the next video. So what is your work is to go through the chapter that till where I have taught you today in this video. So that is, you will again go through the pages, that is 29, which consists of the sources, and also page 31, that is the causes of the rise of Jainism and Buddhism, and about Jainism, that is its main teaching, its doctrines, and the impact and decline of Jainism.